Dear family, welcome to this service of the Holy Eucharist. And today we'll be celebrating Corpus Christi, the body of Christ. But before we get into the service proper, we have a few shout-outs. And the first one goes out to Caitlin Finley, who celebrates her 10th birthday on June 6th. Happy birthday to you, youngster, as you celebrate your huge milestone of 10 years. And then Janice and Michael Perkin, they celebrate their 47th wedding anniversary on June 8th. Happy wedding anniversary, and may the Lord continue to bless you as you continue in this institution of marriage. And then from Bob and Yvonne Temple, they celebrate their 25th wedding anniversary on June 8th as well. They were married right here at St. Mark's with many family members and friends. They would also like you to know that they chose that day because it was the birthday of Yvonne's father, Franz, and Bob's sister, Cassie, both of whom have passed. Happy 25th anniversary to you as well. And then finally, Karen and Alex Greer celebrate their 16th wedding anniversary on June 11th. Happy wedding anniversary to you and to all the couples just mentioned. Finally, we held our Bible study last week, Wednesday, at 7 p.m. And if you want to join, you are free to do so. And you can just contact the office by email, send me a message, and I will add you to the list. But we had the usual trivia at the end of our discussion. And the trivia was very simple. Name the most recent feast. And the answer was Ascension, Pentecost, and Trinity. And the winner of that is our very own, who is actually accompanying me this morning, Miss Jenny Morphew, who won last week's trivia. Very good, Jenny. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit. That we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people.
Please.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, your Son, Jesus Christ, has left to us this meal of bread and wine, in which we share his body and his blood. May we who celebrate this sign of his great love show in our lives the fruits of his redemption. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. But when Christ came as a high priest of the good things that have come, then through the greater and perfect tent, not made with hands, that is not of this creation, Christ entered once for all into the holy place. Not with the blood of goats and calves, but with his own blood, thus obtaining eternal redemption. For if the blood of goats and bulls, with the sprinkling of the ashes of a heifer, sanctifies those who have been defiled, so that their flesh is purified, how much more will the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without blemish to God, purify our conscience from the dead works to worship the living God? For this reason, he is the mediator of a new covenant, so that those who are called may receive the promised eternal inheritance, because a death has occurred that redeems them from the transgressions under the first covenant. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The appointed Psalm 116, verses 11 through 17. Please join us in the refrain. I will lift up the cup of salvation.
I will lift up the cup of salvation and call upon the name of the Lord. I will fulfill my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his servants.
I will lift up the cup of salvation. O Lord, I am your servant. I am your servant and the child of your handmaid. You have freed me from my bonds. I will offer you the sacrifice of thanksgiving and call upon the name of the Lord.
I will lift up the cup of salvation.
I will fulfill my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people, in the courts of the Lord's house, in the midst of you, O Jerusalem. Hallelujah.
I will lift up the cup of salvation. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
On the first day of unleavened bread, when the Passover lamb is sacrificed, his disciples said to him, "Where do you want us to go and make the preparations for you to eat the Passover?" So he sent two of his disciples, saying to them, "Go into the city, and a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him. And wherever he enters, say to the owner of the house, 'The teacher asks, where is my guest room, and where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' He will show you a large room upstairs, furnished and ready. Make preparations for us there." So the disciples sent out and went to the city and found everything as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover meal. While they were eating, he took a loaf of bread, and after blessing it, he broke it, gave it to them and said, "Take, this is my body." Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them, and all of them drank from it. He said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly I tell you, I will never again drink of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God." When they had sung the hymn, they went to the Mount of Olives. The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I will begin this morning's reflection by submitting to you a few names. And it all depends on which strand of Christianity or religion you are from. Because from person to person, each name would mean something slightly different. So there are nuances in all of the names. Even among Anglicans, there will be some nuances. Because if you are high church, low church, broad church, however you want to term it, there are different connotations to each of these. And then if you are of a different Christian faith altogether, then that itself carries a whole load of meanings as well. And here are the names. If I say Mass, what is the connotation? What is the feeling? If I say Eucharist, what is conjured up when I say Eucharist? If I say the Lord's Supper, the Last Supper, if I say manna, the sacred meal, if I say the ordinance, all of these have different connotations. And then if we dig even deeper, there are some other meanings to these words as well. I will not wade into all the deep theological meaning of them, but I will just give you a cursory look at them. If you hear the word consubstantiation, what is conjured up? Because we know that means the remains, that the bread and wine remain the bread and wine. And then people of that belief would say, by faith, they are the same as Christ's body. And then you have another huge word, transubstantiation. What does that mean? There are people of a particular faith who would say to you that these elements actually become the body and blood of Christ. And then there are some people who would say, it's just symbolic. It's only a representation of it all. Whatever take you have, however you assess all of these words, at the end of the day, we can conclude that it is still a good gift. It is a good gift where Jesus Christ used what was common in his day, and down through the ages, we still have this good gift with us. Today we celebrate Corpus Christi. And if we go back to the Latin of it, it simply means the body of Christ. The body of Christ. How does Mark present this to us? Mark's Gospel, Mark chapter 14, verses 12 through 16 and 22 through 26, gives us an historical overview of it by tracing this all the way back to the Passover. The Passover, which marked the liberation of the Israelites from slavery, from captivity in Egypt. The Passover, which became one of the three major feasts of the people. The Passover, or unleavened bread, the Feast of Weeks, and the Feast of Tabernacles. But I like what Jesus did. Jesus took what was readily accessible within the culture, that which was common within the culture, and Jesus reworked it, redefined this festival. And this is how I look at it. Jesus, in essence, was saying, I will bring you from bondage, from your old self, to freedom, to your new self. I will bring you into liberation from the old into the new. Jesus took what was common. This was used regularly in the Jewish meals. Wine, bread, etc., at some point in time, was always used within meals. I'm going to attempt to do something. If I get any part of it wrong, please accept my apology. So there, here is a segue. I'm going to call some countries' names, and then I'm going to suggest a food that is identical or associated with that particular country or culture. And I can say so because I have lived in all of the countries I'm going to call. Antigua. When we hear about Antigua, we hear about fungi, Barbados, flying fish, Canada, poutine, Bahamas, conch, and all kinds of conch. And then the USA, grits. What do they all have in common? What they all have in common is this. Each of those foods gives a particular culture, a particular country, an identity. It helps to identify a people. And we can say the same thing happened in Jesus' day and before that. The Passover identified a particular people, identified a particular act in God's salvation of humanity. Jesus took it then, and he continued to rework this that gave them identity. And he says, now it's going to commemorate the redemption of all humanity through me. And in this remix, we now have Jesus presenting to us the Eucharist. The Eucharist, which is a good gift. It is so good that Jesus commanded us to do it as often as we can in remembrance of him. We know in the early church, this was perhaps the only service initially when they met on a day of the Lord. And back then, they shared in the bread and in the wine. But when we look at the 21st century, and we look at the time we're in, we cannot do it as often as we would like, because we know, of course, COVID has put a stop to it temporarily. And we pray that in a not too distant future, we will be able to commemorate this feast as often as we would like, because this feast of identity also pulls the community together and brings about love and healing. In a few moments, you will hear a hymn, and I take some words from that hymn, and it says, take our bread as take our lives, take our hearts. And then it says, O Father, we are yours. And in this act, it is saying, take our entire being as we take this bread and wine, the body and blood of Christ, and may it bring healing to ourselves. But it's interesting how Mark puts it. Mark says, yes, there is healing. Yes, there is togetherness through this common meal. And Mark sets up the plot. Because in verses 10 through 11, the verses that immediately precede today's gospel. Mark says, then Judas Iscariot, who was one of the 12, went to the chief priests in order to betray him to them. What Mark is saying? Mark is setting up a contrast. Here is Judas's act is about to create chaos, confusion, and division. And now here is Jesus is bringing this common meal to bring about healing within the community, to bring about love. In our Eucharistic prayer that we will hear shortly as well, it is a repeat of the scriptures. And there are two words from the Eucharistic prayer that come from the scripture. First, it says, take. And take. Scriptures is basically saying to us, it is not forced upon us, but is given to us in love. It is up to us to accept it or reject it. Secondly, another word being used for this common meal is eat. And in eating, it says, it is suggestive that we need to eat in order to be alive. We need to eat to live. We need to eat in living and in loving and in healing. What else about this common meal or the common nature of this meal? It gives us another theological point, and that is God is also able to take the mundane things of life and to elevate them to a level that brings people together. The mundane things we take for granted, of loving, of sharing, of kindness, of sincerity, God is able to take these mundane things of life that we take for granted and bring wholeness to us all. Christ, as he elevated the common bread and the common wine, is saying to us, I can also elevate the mundane everyday task of your lives. I say to you, don't let us take these common elements for granted. But allow these common elements to be an occasion to truly celebrate our Lord. In 1 Corinthians, Paul had some issues with the early church. And Paul said, many of you are taking and partaking of this common meal unworthily. In other words, you're still not loving. You're still not caring. You're still not sharing. You're still not healing. And this common meal is for this community to come together in love. As we celebrate, allow the Corpus Christi, allow this meal to bind us together. And I use the words of a chorus sung by Bob Gilman. And he says in his piece, bind us together, Lord. Bind us together with cords that cannot be broken. And this is the communion. Bind us together, Lord. Bind us together in love. Just as the body of Christ binds us in love, we are called to be bound one to the other in love. May this common meal give us that strength and that courage. Amen. Before we have the confession and absolution, let us observe a moment of silence as we pray for the church and the world. In particular, we pray for persons who have succumbed to COVID. Remember them and their loved ones as they grieve. We also Bear in mind our Indigenous brothers and sisters as they deal with the discovery of so many dear precious young ones, as they deal with that pain, that agony from the past. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. Dear friends in Christ, God is steadfast in love and infinite in mercy. He welcomes sinners and invites them to his table. Let us confess our sins, confident in God's forgiveness. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. May Almighty God have mercy upon us, pardon and deliver us from all of our sins, confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in life eternal through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us stand and offer a sign of peace wherever you are, whoever is near you, in your homes, in your cars, wherever you are. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Take a breath. Take our hearts, we love you, take our lives, oh Father, we are yours, we are yours. Yours as we stand at the table you set, yours as we eat the bread our hearts can forget. We are the sign of your love. Yet we are yours, we are yours. Take our bread, we ask you, take our hearts, we love you, take our lives, oh Father, we are yours, we are yours. Your holy people standing washed in your blood, filled yet hungry, we await your food. We are poor, but we've brought ourselves the best we could. We are yours, we are yours. Take our bread, we ask you, take our hearts, we love you, take our lives, oh Father, we are yours.
Receive the gifts we bring before you, and feed us continually with that bread which satisfies all hunger, your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
We give you thanks and praise, Almighty God. Through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Redeemer. He is your living Word, through whom you have created all things. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh of the Virgin Mary and shared our human nature. He lived and died as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. In fulfillment of your will, He stretched out his hands in suffering to bring release to those who place their hope in you. And so he won for you a holy people. He chose to bear our griefs and sorrows and to give up his life on the cross, that he might shatter the chains of evil and death and banish the darkness of sin and despair. By his resurrection, he brings us into the light of your presence. Now with all creation, we raise our voices to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy,
holy, holy, holy, holy Lord,
God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
Holy and gracious God, accept our praise. Through your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, on the night he was handed over to suffering and death, took bread and gave you thanks, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body which is broken for you." In the same manner, he took the cup, saying, "This is my blood which is shed for you. When you do this, you do it in memory of me." Remembering therefore his death and resurrection, we offer you this bread and this cup, giving thanks that you have made us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. We ask you to send your Holy Spirit upon the offering of your Holy Church. Gather into one all who share in these sacred mysteries, filling them with the Holy Spirit and confirming their faith in the truth, that together we may praise you and give you glory through your servant, Jesus Christ. All glory and honor are yours, Father and Son, with the Holy Spirit, in the Holy Church, now and forever. Amen. As our Savior taught us, let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. I am the bread which has come down from heaven, says the Lord.
Give us this bread forever.
I am the vine, you are the branches.
May we dwell in him as he lives in us.
Dear friends, I invite you in this moment, wherever you may be, to receive Christ in communion with the saints and the gathering of God's people, unseen and yet present with us now. Many are made one.
We receive you, Lord Jesus Christ. We welcome your presence in us, and together proclaim our love for you with our hearts, minds, our souls, and our strength. With the saints we worship you, with the angels we adore you, and with your whole church we proclaim your reign.
Come to us, though many, and make us one in you.
Amen.
prayer after communion, let us pray. All praise to you, our God and Father, for you have fed us with the bread of heaven and quenched our thirst from the true vine. Hear our prayer that, being grafted into Christ, we may grow together in unity and feast with him in his kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to God from generation to generation, in the church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever.
Amen.
Christ, you strengthen us with the living bread. May we praise you in love and fellowship. At the last day, raise us all up to share with you in that eternal banquet. And the blessing of God Almighty, whose Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.